Today I am going to discuss about the working of the battery ignition system. So this is the circuit diagram of the battery ignition system. In the battery ignition system, the main components are the battery. Here ammeter is also included, and the ignition switch. And within the ignition switch and the primary winding, there should be a ballast resistor, primary winding, secondary winding, contact breaker point, capacitor and distributor, and also there will be the spark plug. So here the battery, first the battery is used to provide the sufficient amount of electrical energy to the circuit. Ammeter is to measure the amount of the current flowing through this circuit. Ignition switch is used to make or break the circuit whenever we required, by pressing the ignition switch or by clicking the ignition switch. And there should be the ballast resistor which is actually placed between the ignition switch and the primary winding. That is the ballast resistor, which can be made of the metal of the iron, because when the temperature is increasing, in case of the iron metal, it also increases the resistance. So when the resistance is increased according to the Ohm's law, voltage will be, or the current regulation will be reduced. There is the two types of windings are used, that is the primary winding and the secondary winding. In case of the primary winding, 200 to 300 tons are used in case of the primary winding, and secondary windings there are 2100 tons are used. But in some cases of the primary winding, there are 2000 to 3000 tons are used, and the tons are used in the primary winding, that will be multiplied by the 10 times, which will be the tons of the secondary windings. That is, if the 200 to 300 tons are used in the primary winding, so for the secondary winding will be 2000 to 3000 tons will be used. But if in case of the primary winding there are 2000 to 3000 tons are used, then the secondary windings tons will be 20,000 to 30,000. Now contact breaker point is used to make or break the circuit, and it will be regulated by the cam. They will be driven by the engine, and the capacitor, which is used to store the electrical surge energy, and it send it to the distributor by secondary windings. And there is a regulator, which is rotating component, and that distribute the electrical charges to the each individual spark plug according by maintaining the wiring order and spark plug. There is a spark plugs are used. That means there is a four cylinder engine. This circuit diagram is applicable for the four cylinder engine. Four types of spark plugs are there. And in case of the spark plug, there are two types of electrodes are used. That is, one is the body electrode and the other is the ground electrode, and there is a gap between the two electrodes. And when the electrical charge is flowing through this electrode, and it ionizes the gap and generates sparks that helps to burn the air fuel mixture. So here in the circuit diagram, I am now going to explain how the battery ignition system works. So first, when we are clicking the ignition switch to start the engine, then the sufficient amount of electrical energy from the battery will flow through the ammeter to the ignition switch and through the ballast resistor to the primary winding. So now this, when the current is flowing through this primary winding, there is a primary current generates at the coil, and this primary current will be flowing through the contact breaker. So when the contact breaker point is open, then this primary current will be flowing through the capacitor and charges the capacitor. And when the contact breaker point is closed, then this current will be flowing to the ground. Now this primary current charges the capacitor, then there will be a sudden fall of the magnetic field, and sudden collapse of the magnetic field will generate the current into the primary winding, and then the current will be flowing from the primary winding to the capacitor and charges the capacitor. When this charging voltage of the capacitor is much more higher than the battery voltage, then the flowing of the current from the primary winding to the capacitor will be stopped, and now the capacitor will be discharge its voltage or current to the secondary winding. So when the secondary winding is excited and the current will be generated and the magnetic field is highly generated, then the high tension cable will be connected from the secondary winding to the distributor. Then this current will be flowing through the secondary winding to the through the high tension cable to the distributor, and distributor by maintaining the firing order provides the electrical charges to the each individual spark plug to fire or to spark. And this spark plug is basically consisting the two electrodes. One is the body and another is in the ground. When this distributor sends the sufficient amount of electrical charges to the spark plug, this electrical charge is first flowing through the body of body electrode, and then it ionizes the gap between the body electrode and the ground electrode and generates a spark. And due to this spark the spark plug will fire and ignite the sufficient amount of air fuel mixture for the spark plug ignition engine or the spark ignition engine or the SI engine, or you can say that is gasoline engine, or also you can say auto cycle engine, or you can say petrol engine. So this type of battery ignition system is applicable for the petrol engine or gasoline engine, and this is the completely working process of the battery ignition system. Now coming to the circuit diagram of the magneto ignition system, and here I am going to explain about the working of the magneto ignition system, that how the magneto ignition system work. Instead there is a basic difference between the battery ignition system and the magneto ignition system. That is, in case of the battery ignition system, there is a battery is used, but here in the magneto ignition system there is no such batteries are used. Here the armature and the battery is used, armature and the magnets are used. In case of the magneto ignition system, there magnets are rotating around the coil, or the coil may be rotating around the battery. So here the electrical energy can be provided by the two arrangements. That is, one arrangement is rotating armature type, another by the rotating magnet type. So in case of the rotating magnet type or rotating magnet type, here the magnets are rotated and the coils will be fixed, or the armature will be fixed. But when the rotating armature type, that means the armatures or coil will be rotates and the magnets will be fixed. So by rotating of the magnet or by rotating of the armature, the sufficient amount of the electrical current will be electrical energy or the current will be generated. And this current will be first, again similarly here the primary winding and secondary winding will be, primary winding and the secondary winding will be there, and through the first the current will be flowing from the primary winding to the condenser, that is the capacitor, and there will be also a contact breaker point, CB point, that is the, again similar, that is the contact breaker point, CB point is to make or break the circuit, and it is operated by the cam. And similarly condenser means here the capacitor, and also there is a ignition switch we are used, and again four spark plugs we can see here, that is four spark plugs are used, so that this type of magneto ignition, this type of ignition systems are used in the four cylinder engine. Also there is a distributor, is rotating component of distributor is used. So all the circuit diagram is similar to the battery ignition system, but one is the major difference is that in case of the battery ignition system, there is a battery is used, but in case of the magneto ignition system, there is a magnet and the armature are used. And here in the magneto ignition system, the electrical energy can be provided by the two arrangement, that is one is by the rotating magnet or by rotating armature. So when the armature is rotated, then the magnet is fixed, and when the magnet is rotated, and armature is fixed. So here again, similarly, the primary and secondary windings are used. First, the currents will be flowing from the primary winding to the current will be generated, and first flowing from the primary winding to the condenser. When the contact breaker point is open, it flowing through the condenser and charges the condenser. When the contact breaker point is closed, it will be flowing through the contact breaker point and it will be going to the ground. So when the condenser is charged, there is a sudden collapse in the magnetic field. Similarly, in case of the similar as compared to the battery ignition system, when there is a sudden fall of the magnetic field, the primary current, magnetic field of the primary current, then the current will be flowing from the primary winding to the condenser and again charges the condenser. So when the condenser is fully charged, then the current flow from the primary winding to the condenser is completely stopped, and condenser charges, and the condenser sends the electrical energy or sends the current to the secondary winding, and due to this current, secondary windings are magnetized and excited, and there is a high tension cable line which will be attached from the secondary winding to the distributor, and this current will be flowing through this high tension cable from the secondary winding and goes to the distributor. Distributor is nothing but a rating component which maintains the firing order, and similar as compared to the battery ignition system, it will provide the electrical charge, electrical energy to the each individual spark plug to spark or fire the spark plug. Similar to the spark plug, there is a one is the body electrode and the another is the ground electrode, and there is a gap between the body and the ground electrode, and when the electrical charges are flowing through the body electrode, then it will be magnetized, and it ionizes the gap between the body electrode and the ground electrode, and helps to provide the some amount of spark or fire. And during the spark or fire of this spark plug or ignition of the spark plug, then the air fuel mixture will completely ignite or completely burn and generates a thrust onto the piston head. So this is the basic operation of the basic working operation or working progress or working function of the magneto ignition system. And now coming to the basic difference between the or the comparison between the battery and magneto ignition system, that is, in case of the battery ignition system, we all know that is battery is necessary to start the engine, but magneto ignition system, there is no such case occurs. And in case of the battery ignition system, battery maintenance is required, but in the magneto ignition system, this such requirement is not necessary here. Battery ignition system, it is very difficult to start the engine when the battery is completely discharged, but in magneto ignition system, this hazards can be avoided easily because there is no use of the battery. Battery ignition system occupies much more amount of space as compared to the magneto ignition system, whereas the magneto ignition system is very much more compact. And the recharging the battery must be done when the battery gets discharged. This is one hazardous process is required in for the battery ignition system, but in case of magnetic ignition system, there is no such problem of the battery discharge is required because there is no batteries used. And battery ignition system is used in commercial, it is used in cars and light commercial vehicle, but magnetic ignition systems are used in racing car and bike. So these are the comparison, or these are the advantages of the magnetic ignition system over the battery ignition system, or you can say the disadvantages of the battery ignition system, the magnetic ignition system. But there is a one advantage of the battery ignition system is that there is a much more amount of electricity can be generated by the battery ignition system during the ignition, which cannot be generated during the magnetic ignition system, because it depends on the engine speed. Here the magnetic ignition system, magnets are rotating depending on the engine speed, magnetic ignition system magnets are rotated here by depending on the engine speed. But in case of the battery ignition system, there is no dependency on the engine speed. That is the major drawback of the magnetic ignition system. And there is one advantage of the battery ignition system, that is the initial voltage of the battery will be much more higher as compared to the magnetic ignition system. This is the main advantage of the battery ignition system over the magnetic ignition system. And remaining things will be the same. Also, in case of the magnetic ignition system, there should be a ballast resistor to be used within the primary winding and here the condenser. That is the red line. That is the red line which is used in the primary winding to the condenser. That is the red line. There should be the ballast resistor to be used. That here it is not used, not shown here. So today up to this, and next classes we will discuss about the spark advances. Thank you.